We've all been there. If you're working on your camera and you're taking some great pictures, maybe some videos, you've got a lot of stuff saved on the SD card and you haven't backed it up yet to your computer. When all of a sudden something goes wrong, maybe the card gets corrupted or something gets formatted accidentally, or you plug it into the wrong camera and it reconfigures the settings, and all of a sudden you've lost all of your photos from the whole day. Well, don't panic, because it's actually possible in most circumstances to recover some, if not all, of the data that was accidentally deleted off the card. So if this ever happens to you, what I would do is remove your SD card right away. Be sure not to write any new information to the card, because that could overwrite the old information. You want to take the card out of your camera or out of your computer or whatever device it happened with, and I'm going to show you how you can use some software from EaseUS to try to recover all of the data that was lost on that card. This works for SD cards, micro SD cards, really any type of card, and depending on the circumstances, you just might be able to save your data. So that being said, I'm going to hop over to the computer and show you what to do. All right, so I'm now here at the computer. I'm going to show you the step-by-step process of exactly what you have to do to recover your files. So the first thing we're going to do is head to the EaseUS website to download the software. Now, this is the link that we're going to use, EaseUS.com/DataRecoveryWizardPro. So you can see it on screen now, and it'll also be in the description down below. So we're going to go to EaseUS.com, hit the enter key there. That's going to bring us to the Data Recovery Wizard website. So here you can see they do have a free trial available, or if you do want to pay for the premium license, you can do so with the Buy Now button. As you can see, the Pro version costs $69.95, which has unlimited data recovery, you can preview before recovery, and you can even get help from EaseUS specialists. So I'm going to go ahead and go here. We've actually already got this going, so I'm going to do the free trial. All right, that's going to prompt a little download right there. I'm going to go ahead and run that. Okay, let me pull that over there. I'm just going to take a look at the custom install. That should be fine. I'm going to go ahead and install that now. Installation is complete. I'm going to go ahead and go to start now to open up the program. So as you can see here, once you open it up, you're going to have a list of all the different disks here. Now I'm going to go ahead and activate mine since I am using the premium version, but if you're using the free trial, you would go ahead without activation. So I'm going to go ahead and verify with my code now, just doing that off screen for a second. So since I do have that account, I'm going to go ahead and enter that code in now, but you can also try with the free trial version. So here we are on the main program screen. I'm going to expand the window just a bit. So I found out the hard way it doesn't scale too well when you're working with two different monitors at different resolutions, but this is kind of what it looks like here. As you can see, we've got the different disks available. Now I'm going to show you what I did. I actually created a disk on my SD card. So I'm going to go ahead and plug in my SD card right now. There we go. I'm using just a little external adapter here so I can read the SDs. So I'm plugging the SD card into the SD card reader, like so. Now I'm going to pull that up just like this, this PC, removable disk. As you can see, I've loaded up these three pictures. Dog, dog two, and dog three. Some adorable puppy pictures. What I'm going to do here is go here and intentionally delete these. I'm going to delete these files. They've been permanently deleted. So this is the situation you may find yourself in. So we've got the disk on there. I'm going to close the program, start from ground zero. Program is closed. You can see we've just inserted the SD card and all the files have been accidentally deleted. So what I'm going to do is open up the EaseUS Data Recovery Wizard here. Let's open that up. That's going to go like this, read the disk information. It's going to ask you to please wait. So now it's going to give you a list of different things that you can recover. The hard drives, local disks, different external devices, and also other locations like the recycle bin or things like that. Now, if you want to scan a particular folder, if something in a particular folder went missing, you can certainly do that using the select folder option. For me, I'm going to scan the entire device, which in my case is the F drive. That is my SD card. So I'm going to click scan over here next to that drive. And look at this, you can see it's scanning through the entire SD card here. So already the quick scan is complete. I'm going to take a look at the deleted files. And look at that. We've got dog right here, dog over there. Dog 2. See that? So already the dogs, these are completely deleted. They're not in the recycle bin. They're not stored on the computer. You would think they're completely gone, but looking at the recovery software, you can see that the images are here. You can actually even load a preview of the image from the SD card that's been deleted. And now when you're ready to recover them, it's as simple as checking these checkboxes just like that, clicking that recover button. And now you can pick the folder you want to save them to. Now it's worth mentioning that it's actually a bad idea to save it back to the original drive because that could overwrite some of your data. So don't do that. Instead, what you should do is just save them someplace safe, like perhaps your desktop on your computer. I'm going to make a new folder. I'm going to call it dogs. And I'm going to save these images right in there. All right, so now you can see it opens up this window right here. And these are the images. You can see the name for this one is a little bit messed up. It's, you know, Og 3, for example, instead of Dog 3. But it's pretty close. You can see the images seem to be completely intact, even though they were totally deleted. This is a bit of a best case scenario, since they were deleted right before I ran the software. What's happening now in the background is it's actually running a complete scan to find all the files that were ever kind of on here. So this even looks like old videos and whatnot. Let's see what we got.
For reference, right, this is a test.
So this is actually footage from another video I did many, many months ago that I had no idea was actually on here. So just to show you the effectiveness of the software, you know, this is stuff from that's months old.
So this is what they sound like. Again, they're right around the same.
You can see some of it is perfectly intact. Some of it looks a bit corrupted, looks a little bit off. But as you can see, this is all available here to you. And with this software, you can choose to recover that. So again, I'm going back with the escape key. These are files that lost their original name. We got MP4s. Wow, this is actually really cool. So as you can see, there's so much data that was deleted off this drive that went missing, but is actually still available. You can even play it back right in the application. And as you can see, it's scanning through. It's going to look through this entire drive and see what was missing. So I'm going to let it do that. I'm going to pause this video, and I'll get back once we're done. All right, so as you can see, I've let it complete its entire scan. It doesn't actually show you how much time elapsed once it was completed, unfortunately, but it wasn't too long to scan through this entire 16 gigabyte card. So, you know, just to go through here, so we got deleted files. These are the dogs right here. These are the ones that were deleted, but I actually formatted this card multiple times. We've actually got some of the old videos on here. From videos I've done, you know, a long time ago, like months and months ago. This thing has been formatted multiple times. It's been overwritten. It's been deleted. So it's pretty impressive to see that these are actually still here. You know, you can see some of the files that were more recently deleted. It has their original directory and their original locations and their original names. Some of it has varying degrees of degradation. You know, some stuff, we have the files right here. Some of the stuff is missing the name, but it still has the file, so we can check through JPEGs, for example. See if we can get a preview. You know, we're getting some semblance of, you know, recovering that data from that JPEG. Even if your card got completely formatted, even if everything got deleted, there's a pretty good chance you could actually still go back and recover. You know, the only circumstances under which all your data would be lost is if you've filled up your card, formatted or deleted it, and then you've gone back and filled it up again completely. If it's completely gone, that could overwrite your old files, but for the most part, a lot of your old files will still be here, which is pretty impressive. And obviously, once you find the files you like, you can just check them off like so. You can click Recover, and then you just choose wherever you want to save them. So the recovery process really is that easy. It's basically just three simple steps. You just got to open up and pick your SD card in the program. Then you let the program scan through the card to find all your files, and then you can just check the files you want to recover. And just like that, they reappear magically on your computer as if they were never lost. And what's so great about this software too is that it's so versatile. It's not just for recovering deleted pictures. You can repair corrupted photos on a card like JPEGs, PNGs, GIFs, really any type of file. If it's damaged, it could be repaired using this software. You can also repair corrupted videos on your SD card. It also allows you to record data from, for example, an SD card that's been infected with a virus or a malware or something. You could still recover from that device. I mean, you can even find hidden files that were on, you know, your computer or your card, stuff that you didn't even realize was there, can actually be uncovered using this software. And it also works on both Windows and Mac computers. So it's a pretty good piece of software, a valuable tool to have in your tool belt when you're dealing with data, when you're working with cameras, when you're working with SD cards. And as you can see, it works very well. All right, so that is it for the video. I really hope this has been helpful. If you do want to try to follow those steps, make sure to check out that EaseUS SD card recovery software. And of course, feel free to like the video, leave a comment with your thoughts or questions down below, and feel free to subscribe to the YouTube channel.